kind of statements? Is it quarterly statements, annual statements, monthly statements? So how does an insider know what's going on with their investment?
Yeah, all of our investors get access to a client portal. So they have access to quarterly statements there, but they can always reach out if they need, you know, quarterly statements are there as well as annual statements and the tax slips as required. But, you know, absolutely they can reach out at any time and we can generate a statement for them. It's not an issue. So, you know, our, traditionally the share price, it gets, the new share price gets posted monthly. So that's when, and we pay our distributions on the 15th of every month. So that's when people can, you know, they get to ring the register every month, basically. So, yeah, some like to see the, some like to see, it's like when, you know, when my parents would go to the bank with their book and they want to see each single line item in the book, that's why they would go to the teller. So for some investors, it's like that. They want to ring the register every month. So yeah, I'm happy to provide that information.
My mom still wants that passbook.
I have a 4-digit passbook from my first account.
Yeah. So I was at Scotia, Scotiabank the other day and there was an older lady in front of me and she goes, can I have my bank book up? And I literally, for the first time, saw they're like, unfortunately, we don't do that anymore. It's all like,
oh no, must have broken her heart.
I know. Clifford, thank you so much for joining us on Brunch with REC this Saturday. I mean, we are very appreciative of your time.
Thank you.
I think you're going to be surprised with the people and the amount of people that are going to be reaching out to you. I know we were all at a investor conference this past weekend, and we had a blast. We met a lot of new people. A lot of them are probably watching right now. And just wanted to thank you from all of us here at REC, as well as the REC community, for your time today.
My pleasure. No, you guys have been a pleasure to deal with, and so is the rest of the REC family. So thank you, guys. Have a great Saturday.
Awesome. Thank you, Cliff.
Okay. Care, cheers. Bye-bye.
To everyone who's still with us live, and if you're watching the recording, thank you. We appreciate you as well. We hope this was valuable and it was timely. Simos mentioned it earlier. It's very, very timely in our opinion because you're going to be hearing the words RRSPs in the next 2-3 days. I'm sure if you turn on the TV, that's what majority of the commercials are about. And the banks are going to try to get you to invest with them. And even if you put the money into the bank because you need to meet that deadline, there is no deadline to meet with a Clifford and an Equiton or any of our other referral sources that we can actually put you in touch with. There is no deadline for that. It's ongoing all the time. But if you want to get more information, all you got to do is send that email to info@reccanada.com. I think it was another great brunch, my friend.
Good point, buddy. And I just want to expand on it, that there is no rush. So what Jazz is referring to is the only rush one has is to actually meet the deadline of getting your 2020 income to get that RSP in the bank. So get your RSP in the bank. Nobody's selling you anything. Once your RSP is in, you're going to choose it. There is no rush. So what Cliff does and what any of our other registered fund strategic partners do is once your RSP is in place, you can move a specific portion into a self-directed account where you take control of it. So don't think you're under pressure to make decisions over 2 days. You have zero pressure, and you can take all the time you need to do the due diligence required. The only thing you have to worry about, as Jazz mentioned, is actually getting your RSP in if that is a part of your tax strategy.